One common request I get is I have data in Excel and I want some reminders based on that date column. To make it a little more interesting, let's look at a scenario where these are PO dates. I want to check the status. If the status is empty and 15 days have passed, then I want to be reminded. I don't want one reminder for every row. I want a combined reminder once a day. This kind of automation is best done using Power Automate. Power Automate has a copilot nowadays, but we are going to do this from scratch. That way you will learn better. I'm going to create a new flow. We want this to run automatically at 8:30 in the morning. That's called scheduled flow. I choose the frequency as daily and time as 8:30 and then click on create. It creates the first step, which is recurrence. It automatically opens the copilot pane, but I'm going to close it right now. We'll see it later. The next step is to get the data from Excel file. The Excel file has a table and the name of the table is PO data. So click on the plus sign, add an action, search for Excel list rows present in a table. Every time you add a new step, it's always better to rename the step so that it becomes easier to understand for you and others, and it helps you in troubleshooting as well. Location is OneDrive. I'll choose the correct folder and I'll also choose the table. PO data is the table name. One extra thing we need to do here, because we're going to compare some dates, the date time format has to be compatible with Power Automate. So use the ISO format. Now we are going to go through all the table rows, pick up the ones which are to be handled, and then I need to put that data somewhere. So I need a temporary space or a variable. So I'm going to add an action and say initialize a variable. I have to give a name to the variable. We're going to use it for notifications. So notification text is the name. It is going to contain text. It's also technically called string, and currently there is nothing in it. At this stage now, I need to go in the loop and do something for every row in the table. So let's add an action called for each. Apply to each what? So the previous step was get PO data, which is a table. So click on this lightning symbol and just take the PO data. So now whatever happens here, it'll iterate through every row. Now we want to look for two conditions, compare the dates and check for the status not being empty. So add a step to look for condition. First, we will make sure both the dates which we are comparing and the base date are in the same format, and that is done by putting some function. Format date time. This side, I'm going to compare the date from the PO date column. So dynamic content, this is get PO data, and from here I'll get the PO date. And the formatting I want to make like this. And I'm checking if this is less than today's date minus 15. How do we do that? We again need a function. Today's date you get by using a function called UTC now, which is like a today function in Excel. Now I want to subtract 15 days. The function to use is called add days. Open bracket, close bracket, but we need to say how many days I want. So instead of adding, we want to subtract. So I say minus 15 will be added. And then format date time, open close bracket. But before that, match the format. This is one condition. The second condition is to check whether the status is empty. I'm going to look at the length. Length means how many characters are there, but there may be some spaces. Spaces are also counted as characters, so I'm going to trim it. From where? Oh, the status column. So if the length is zero, that means status column is empty. Condition true means both these things are correct. Condition false means we don't need to remind ourselves about that particular row. False means I don't need a reminder for that row. So nothing is going to happen here. Under true, I'm just going to add details from that particular row into this variable. That's called append a variable. It'll ask me the name of the variable, and then I have to specify multiple values. So the first thing I'm going to do is again take the date. The date, of course, comes from dynamic content, PO date. And now I want to put the vendor and description. That's easy. I can pick it up from previous steps. This may add and apply to each, but that's not really required. Just remove that. And hyphen description. I'm adding a line break after the description. BR is the HTML way of saying line break. So after this entire table is traversed one row at a time, I will have the content in this particular variable. Now I need to check, is this variable having anything? Because maybe there were no rows which require notification. If it is empty, I don't want to do anything. So now I need to put a condition. And what am I doing here? Check if the notification is empty. How do we do that? We already saw the method trim of what? Dynamic content notification text. And I want to make sure that it is greater than zero. If that is true, that means I need to process the text and send it as a notification. If it is false, I will simply do nothing. Now let's add an action called send mail. There are a lot of connectors through which you can send mails. I'm going to use Office 365 Outlook. Send an email V2. In the mail, I need to put email IDs of people. To manage the email IDs, I've created a separate table in the same Excel file. The name of the table is notify list, and it has only one column called mail2. And in that, the first row, I put email IDs separated by semicolon. So coming back to Power Query, I need to pick up that data. I will have to put a step before email and get that table. We already know how to do that. List rows present in table. I'll choose the notify list table from OneDrive. Click on the send an email. And here I will put custom value, and that value we will pick up from get email IDs mail to column. It is still a table, so it automatically puts a for each loop. Don't worry about it. In our case, we have only one row, so only one mail is going to go. I'll put a hard coded subject, and in the body text, I'm simply going to put the notification text. Of course, I can put other additional embellishments, but this serves our purpose. And after all this is done, we will test it out. But before that, it's a good idea to save it. While saving, it will check for errors. Very important. Some errors are bound to appear. So it's telling me apply to each contains invalid expression. So the mistake was I'm comparing after trimming the length of status. I should be comparing it with zero. Right now, I forgot to mention a value. That's why it's giving me an error. Now everything should be OK. Let's save this. So now let's save this. If there are no errors, then the test button will get enabled. We have to test this manually. Click on the test button. Click on the run flow button again, and then click on done. Now you'll see all these things lighting up. It shows you how long each step took, and final step is email. At any stage, you can click on every step, look at the inputs, outputs, properties, and more. I'm going to go to the send email action, and it has sent me for Oracle Database and Max Office adoption. Let's check if it has sent the mail correctly. Here are the two notifications. And if you look at the data, these are the two dates which are before 20th October, that is 15 days from today, and their status is empty. Now I'm going to type something in one of the status rows, and then we will test again. Now in the email, we should receive only one row for Oracle. So every day this is going to wake up. Only if there are rows which require your attention, then it is going to send a mail. And that's exactly what we wanted. If you go to the Home tab, and if you have the correct preview tenant, as of now, you will get Copilot, which is only in preview stage. So you have to create an environment by going to the wheel, admin center, create an environment, which currently should be US preview. And then you will see this text box where you can ask what you want in simple language, and then it'll build the flow for you. That's the Copilot feature. So I'm going to type, create a reminder from Excel data. It rephrases things. So this looks good. This is AI in action. It's thinking what you have said. Now it's asking me to review the connected apps and services. There should be green tick mark to indicate correct connection. And now the create flow button is active. Click on it. This will open the editor, and it has created a basic shell. Yes, you can ask it to do various things, but parameters you still have to specify. I hope this gave you a good idea about how it works. Now I need help from you. If you found this useful, don't you think there must be millions of people who can benefit from it? So now we can help them. If you like, share, subscribe, click on the bell icon and tell me whether it was useful to you by putting a comment or even put your queries. All that is going to make YouTube understand this content is good, and then YouTube will show it to more and more people. And that's how you and me together can make the world a more efficient place. So that's it for now. Thank you.